The other big stories we're following at 11, the Kruger Rock Fire burning a few miles south of Estes Park, and a deadly plane crash involving an air tanker trying to help with firefighting efforts. We have team coverage this morning, and we want to start with Denver 7's Veronica Acosta, who is hearing from a man who saw that plane go down.
And you know, Brett Rios, he was out all day yesterday taking pictures of the Kruger Rock Fire. It was around 6:30 in the evening when he says he saw that air tanker making its rounds, and then it disappeared. Listen to this.
Literally, I'm just sitting there holding my camera, getting ready to take a photo, and then all of a sudden, like this 80, 90 mile per hour gust of wind just comes barreling through, almost knocks me and my camera over. And then all of a sudden, I just see this intense bright flash. It lights up the entire sky.
And our Denver 7 crews captured video of that tanker up in the sky about an hour or so before it went down. Our partners at ABC News were able to confirm the tail number on that plane in the video matches the tail number of the plane that came down. The pilot was the only person on board and the only person killed. Rio says he called 911 and listened to the radio, and that's when he heard this.
The voice comes on again, tanker down, tanker down. And I was like, okay, something's up. And then another voice comes on and says, tanker crashed. And pretty much realized my worst thoughts had come true, and that I had probably more than likely captured the last images of this person working and doing his job.
So now it is all up to the FAA to investigate what exactly happened here. That process is expected to start this morning. We're in Estes Park. I'm Veronica Acosta, Denver 7.